This is a story told to me by a Japanese friend of mine. He swore it was the absolute truth, but he refused to tell me exactly where in Japan it happened. He said that two people died that night, and he was questioned by the police many times. This is what he said. At the time, I was 17 years old and was working for a local hardware store as a cashier. One night after work, some of my coworkers and I decided to go grab a bite to eat. Our store manager decided to go along with us. To get to the restaurant, we had to drive on a long suspension bridge. There were five of us in total, so we decided to take two cars. The manager and two of my coworkers drove in the car in front, and my friend and myself drove in the car behind them. We started out straight after work, but the manager took a wrong turn, so by the time we reached the bridge, it was almost twilight. There was a light rain, and the bridge was covered in a strange, wispy fog. The manager drove across the suspension bridge, and we followed close behind in another car. However, when we reached the center of the bridge, the manager's car came to a sudden halt. We were puzzled. We didn't understand why our boss had stopped in the middle of the bridge. After waiting a few minutes, we began to get impatient. Since they showed no signs of moving, I was about to get out of my car and see what the trouble was. Just then, we saw the manager's rear car door open, and my coworkers who were sitting in the back seat got out. I opened my car door and was about to ask them what was wrong, but the words died in my throat. We heard our coworkers screaming their lungs out, looking all around them. Suddenly, the two joined hands and started running like crazy. They rushed over to the side of the suspension bridge and threw themselves over the guardrail. Horrified, I rushed over to the side and looked over, but I couldn't see anything because of the fog. The drop was over 100 feet. Nobody could have survived that. Nobody. I stood there for a few minutes in silence, staring down into the fog. I couldn't believe that that had happened. I mean, who would have? I ran over to check on my manager, but I found him crouched over the steering wheel, gripping it so tightly that his knuckles were white. Tears were streaming down his face, and he kept muttering under his breath over and over, "I want to do it, but I can't. I want to do it, but I can't. I want to do it." I called the police, and when they arrived, they had to pry the manager's hands off the steering wheel. They took him away in an ambulance, still muttering and mumbling like a madman. Later that night, the bodies of the two co-workers were fished out of the river. My friend and I were persistently questioned by the police, but they couldn't shed any light on what had happened. The police seemed to think it was some sort of weird suicide pact. A few months after that, I went to visit the store manager, who was recovering in a mental hospital. After some small talk, he turned the conversation to the strange event that took place that night. The store manager beckoned me closer and whispered in my ear. He told me, as they were driving across the bridge, he was shocked to see a woman suddenly standing in the fog. She stood right in front of the car, and he had to slam on his brakes to avoid hitting her. All of a sudden, he noticed that the mist was creeping closer, encircling the car. Then, from within the fog, a group of children appeared. Before they knew what was happening, the children surrounded the car and began beating on the windows and the doors with their fists. The children began chanting, "Come join us, come join us, come join us." The manager said that the children's voices echoed around in his head and he felt powerless to resist it. He clung onto the steering wheel for dear life. At that moment, he dearly wanted to die, but some small part of him desperately wanted to live. He said he heard the co-workers in the back seat screaming as the children opened the door and dragged them out into the fog. The terrified manager had to fight the urge to get out of the car. After hearing my manager's story, I had chills up my spine. As I rose to leave, he grabbed me roughly by the arm and whispered, "I think that's what happened, but don't tell the police. They'll never believe you." Sometimes I don't even believe myself. Just promise me one thing. Promise me that you will never cross that bridge, but they'll come after you and drag you to your death as well.